Good evening. The Prime Minister has joined tens of thousands of people demanding an end to domestic violence against women. Anthony Albanese calling a snap meeting of premiers after declaring it a national crisis. With yet another woman killed this weekend, the common cry, enough is enough.
An epidemic of untold tragedy, a tally of women who've died at the hands of current or former male partners. The Prime Minister joining a large rally in the nation's capital, facing the signs of sadness head on.
Pretty simple message.
Simple message, I wish I could write, Paul.
It started, though, awkwardly, saying he and his Minister for Women had asked to speak but were denied.
And that's fine. I respect the organiser's right to do that.
That's a full-out lie.
To do that.
But speak he did, admitting everyone has to do better.
We need to change the culture, we need to change attitudes. We need to change the legal system. We need to change the approach by all governments.
It will be the key topic of a national cabinet meeting on Wednesday. In Melbourne, more than 10,000 marched, decrying a system that is failing women. Emotion here. Raw.
Enough is enough. I'm 64 and this saddens me to death.
My daughter Katie Haley was murdered in 2018 by her partner. So I'm here to support my grandkids, my kids, but all women.
It's put tears in your eyes. It's just upsetting. It's just too many girls. It's got to stop.
Through Brisbane City, thousands again drawn by a call to action.
Just to show them, I'm getting sorry, just that they deserve to grow up in a safe, supportive country.
Everywhere a sense of growing frustration that there's more talk than action as women continue to die in growing numbers. On the Gold Coast, a stark and vivid reminder of women and children who've been killed in a domestic situation in the past 16 months, with governments in the spotlight for not doing enough.
Too many programs are not meeting their obligations. We're not seeing change. You know, every 4 days a woman is dying in this country now.
One possible measure gaining traction across the country, electronic monitoring for alleged offenders out on bail.
It can protect a victim against physical harm, but it won't protect them against financial harm, interference with their bank accounts, internet abuse, phone abuse and so on. It's an important part of the jigsaw puzzle.
It touched a nerve at a rally in Orange in central western New South Wales, just 100 kilometres from Forbes, where 28-year-old Molly Ticehurst was killed this week, allegedly at the hands of her former partner, while out on bail for her alleged rape.
The injustice. Molly asked for help and the help wasn't given. And just like hundreds of other women before Molly, they've asked for help and the help hasn't been given. Something has to change.
But change seems so far away. In Perth, yet another woman killed this weekend, mother of four Erica Hay, found dead in her burning home. Her 35-year-old male partner has faced court, charged with her murder, all hanging heavy on the hearts of those who marched in that city. On the New South Wales north coast, flowers in the water, each to mark a death. A minute's silence in memory of too many women lost. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
A huge crowd has brought the heart of Melbourne to a standstill, demanding an end to violence against women. The Premier was among those bolstering the cause, as many demand politicians do more. Stephanie Anderson joined them.
They came in their thousands, frustrated, angry, and adamant their message must be heard.
Men's violence has to go!
I keep getting really emotional walking down here and thinking about her, because we lived a certain life that had an expectation of violence, and I just don't want that for her.
Enough is enough. We have to stop this.
Starting at the State Library, they brought Swanston Street to a standstill, the show of strength stretching several city blocks.
What is it that made you want to be a part of today?
I think it's kind of the least I could do, I guess. That's the feeling.
It's emotionally overwhelming to see so many people here. It's great.
In the sea of faces and signs, there's photos of the women whose lives have been lost this year. 32 names were read from the stage at Federation Square and a flower laid for each one.
Samantha Murphy, Hannah Maguire, Ashley Good. We can't change the story for the women killed this year or in years past, but we can remember and honour them.
If we all call it out, we can make change and everyone can hopefully have a better life. Yeah, kids like my grandkids don't have to grow up without a mum.
We've all got mothers, sisters, aunties. We need to stop.
Today, the Premier and Federal Attorney General were front and centre as the crowd demanded that the system be strengthened.
That is why there's more work we're going to do here in Victoria. I want to make that absolutely clear.
We are always up for change to see if we can do things better. We know that governments have to do more.
This is one of more than a dozen demonstrations being held across the country this weekend, with big cities, regional centres and smaller communities uniting in the call for change, including towns where violence has hit incredibly close to home. Ballarat gathered on Friday and Cobram came together this morning. Communities grappling with the heartache that's got this crowd refusing to be quiet.
We need to make a noise. It's the only way we'll be heard. So the louder the better.
Stephanie Anderson, Nine News.